We're trying to figure out a safe way to mount this cage. As you can see, we've made these plates that we'll put onto the floor, and we'll mount the cage onto this. But we need to get it safe. So we're trying to use this, the rocker. The inner rocker is a pretty strong place. I'd like to tie it into here too, which I think we can do with a separate plate. And then we can mount the feet on here. To just mount these feet onto this sheet metal is not a safe way to mount a cage. Now, some cars are better than others, but this particular one has a pretty flimsy floor, and as you can see, it's starting to get a little rusty too. So that's kind of the story on how to get it in. We'll tack it and get everything, all the bars lined up, and then we'll come back in. We did talk to Auto Power, who made this cage. It is a bolt-in cage, as we said, but they said it is plenty safe and even safer to weld it in. They said there's nothing wrong with that theory that we had in our last conversation. Welding a cage into an old car like this is a pretty tough job. You've got a thick plate you're trying to weld to a thin unibody. Everything's dirty. I mean, we cleaned it out the best we could with a grinding wheel, but you still got a little bit of seam sealer and a little bit of rust and a little bit of dirt you're dealing with. You've got to weld it hot. You've got to turn your welder up an extra notch. You've got to kind of know what you're doing, or you'll burn through. You kind of put a lot of your focus on the plate, which is your thicker metal, and then ease over to the thinner metal. Not really a job for a beginner. It can be done. We're using a big machine. It's an HTP 220 volt machine. It's been a good welder for us, and we'll get it.